Happy Sabbath.
Yes, sir. It's so nice really to see you this morning. Just to be in this place, worship our God, and also especially study His Word. Now, remember this. This is one of the things that I really found out, that there are things like worshiping God and things like that. Really, God is not so much interested in it. You know that? You know, God is not so much interested in the most of the things that we do. He's interested about something new. Yeah, so I found out that the Lord is not so much excited with the thing that we do. But He wants to see if our heart is ready to meet the Lord. That's the only thing. And friends, as we know that this national Sunday law, this will be is the issue which will be over the seal of God and the mark of the beast. And when this thing will pass, the only question that we're going to have in our heart will be, am I ready for the coming of the Lord? Am I ready to meet the Lord? And this is have to be really our thinking, and we should actually engage and thinking only in this subject. Because until we think at that point, my brothers and sisters, we are actually really in trouble, Now, I praise God that we can come here and study together. You want to study? You want to study?
Yes.
Now, you want to study? Because some people, we have been accustomed to go to church, listen to a sermon, and then we come out, that's it done. We go, and some of us, you know, I've expressed that too. Even when I was a little one, I didn't like going to church and listen to people preaching that and this. I was not really excited. But brothers and sisters, you know, the time for us to get away from sermon which entertain us does not tell us what is about to come, we need to start listening to those kind of sermons. I mean, we need to make sure that everything that we are doing is to study the Word of God. Because we studied this week, we found out that there will be what? A time of what? A time of what? Daniel chapter 12. There will be a time of what? Time of trouble such as what? Never was. And if there will be a time of trouble such as never was, we are told that we have to have an experience with Jesus such as what? We have never had. And we also need to pray such as we're never praying. We need to study the Bible, this. Such as we never see. And we need to actually, my friend, I'll tell you. If our Bible is a phone, I just want to say, if our Bible that we are using is a phone or an iPad, will not be ready for the coming of the Lord. I'm telling you, amen? If our Bible that we are using right now, when we see that all evil forces are actually gathered together to break down, you know, not just right now, they will be problems in this already. And my question is, will Adventist exist from this time on? Have you ever wondered another question? Will Seventh-day Adventist exist? Because Seventh-day Adventists, they are Protestant. Will they exist or they will compromise? Many people right now ask, even though this was here, many people was like asking, what's going to happen? Are you going to sign for an ecumenical movement that all of us need to be one? Because right now Adventists at stake, you know that? Because there is only one option, or to sign or to be in trouble already. Now my brothers and sisters, and most of us right now, we don't know this. We don't know what is going on. How many people really know what is really going on? How many think that the Protestant thing already is actually in war? What did it do? It's happening. That's fine. What did it do with the Protestant thing? My brother and sister, we are in trouble. And right now, I'm telling you, friends, we are not ready for the coming of the Lord. Whether you are waiting for the Lord or not, but we are not ready for the coming of the Lord. There is something, listen, I will not tell you, oh, you start doing this and this and this. Before even the thing that God is asking us to stop using it for the embrace, there is something greater that you have in our heart. Because only when the heart is changed that we are people who be willing to do what God wants us to do. My friends, I want to really invite you to really pray. But let me show you the reason why. I'm going to pass a little bit more to this. This screen, sorry. why I'm telling you this? It's because of this. Now, notice this. The reason why we need to get ready, because some of us, we are not aware of anything. The years are gone, some of us are here in the Philippines, and things are going on, but I don't follow anything. But, this is, notice this. This is what's in the White House. Anyone remember what year was this? Huh? Anyone remember what year they actually approved same-sex marriage? Anyone remember? 2000 what?
2004.
Super good. But then, notice this. In the same day when they did this, outside of the White House, after this is not there, this is not the White House, this Supreme Court. And I say, people came out, and these guys, then you know, everything that was in the closet come out. Those gay was hiding themselves, they come out. Listen carefully. Being a homosexual, listen carefully. It's a sin just as other sin, just as lie, just as any other sin that you can commit. Now, but the Bible says, because listen to this, the Bible says Jesus loved the sinner, but he had what? He had the sin. Jesus, what he did was, he told the who? The woman. He said, woman, you see, he said, woman, what? Neither I condemn you. Go on. So she is a receiver, but he said, go and do what? That's how Jesus. But today we change everything. We hate the sinner and we love the sinner. I mean the sinner. We're supposed to hate the sin and love the sin. We change everything. And listen to me. These people, we should love them. But we should say what is wrong and what we should not bring it. Because the Bible condemns. Now, we cannot condemn the men who practice that, but we have to condemn the practice. Amen? Amen? Now, that's the teaching. Now, the reason why we're in trouble is that this man also say, actually emphasize that this gay man does not work. He's strengthened. Then we found out that actually there is a counterfeit. There's a counterfeit what? I mean, there is a true marriage, and you what? God created this. Now let's read this one. Father, bless your word as we read it. For we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. This it says, then marriage is what? Marriage and the son. As their origins. Now there's a comma here, can you see? As their origins, and it says, twin institution for what? So these two are twin institutions. Now when you say twin, it's something that some people, when people are twin, when they're born, they go away in the same day, in the same hour, in the same minute. Am I right or wrong? Yes. Now then it says, these twin institutions are for the benefits of God. It's number one for the glory of God in the benefit of you know, marriage and the Sabbath is for the benefit of humanity. That's why Jesus said, the Sabbath was made not for what? Was made for men, and not made for what? For the Sabbath. And they said, then as what? The Creator joined the hands of this holy prayer. What happened? He said unto them, men shall do what? Leave his father and mother shall what? Cleave unto his wife, and they shall be what? And he announced the law of marriage for how long? For the children of how many? How many children? All the children of what? How long? So that means marriage and what? The Sabbath is something that had to be until the cross of time. Listen, brothers and sisters. Everything that God does, Satan has a counter. Everything, friends, everything. You can tell me and you can ask me anything that God made. Can I ask you, what is the counterfeit of that thing? Maybe I want to find out. There is a counterfeit. There is a counterfeit prayer. There is a counterfeit ministry. There is a counterfeit evangelism. There is a counterfeit, what is this? Prophets. There is false prophet. Everything that God does, there is a counterfeit. And the counterfeit almost look like the same. Do the same thing, perform the same way. Everything's almost the same. You know, we should actually ask ourselves what we do. Now, let me show you this. What is a counterfeit parent? Anyone know? What is a counterfeit servant? It's called, this is a counterfeit parent. Is this what God created from the beginning? No. It looks good thing. You know, actually, you know, this is on YouTube. This is a minister from even God. I was listening, I don't know why. It's a PUC. This man was preaching. The title of his sermon was Adam and Steve. Did you hear that? You saw that, my friend? Okay, well, last time I mentioned that. So for those of you who need to take a look at this, this is amazing. The title is Adam and Steve. He was preaching this message in the week of prayer. And you could see what he meant. What he meant is really what you are thinking right now. Like now what he's saying, that people, actually God will accept homosexuality on here, on the church, even in heaven. There's no such thing like that. God cannot accept what he did not create. Now, a sinner can come to the sanctuary, yes, and out of confess the sin. But God must change a sinner to what? From sinner to what? Sin. Now, the sanctuary was made for the sinners, but the sanctuary is a place that we become changed. Amen? Mm-hmm. It's a place that when we go there, because by beholding Jesus, Jesus doesn't look like us. And when we get there, the tendency, not just the tendency, the very purpose of that sanctuary is to change us. It's to make us change by beholding the love of God on the cross, moving the holy place, or to the most holy place. That's our brother actually song that actually we are so thankful that Jesus got this word actually in the altar. And yet to finish this word in the most holy place. But notice this, the counterfeit Sabbath is called what? Sunday law. This will be national Sunday law. This will be national in the U.S. Right now in the U.S., this law, this homosexuality or same-sex marriage was passed as a law. You know that? It was no longer something that for people, oh, whether you want it or not, it was a law. So if you preach about, or if you preach against same-sex marriage, you are in trouble. Right now, there are people that no longer preach, but there are people who are bold, they are really preach. Because brothers and sisters, this is, we are coming to a time of Sodom and Gomorrah. And I'm telling you, if you want to see, study the Bible, then you see that we are in the verge of everything. The Bible says, when Sodom and Gomorrah, in Sodom and Gomorrah, the Bible says, the angel came to the city, but the same set of, what's that, the gays, or maybe we can say, what is this, homosexual people, they came, they knocked the door of who? No. I remember about the priest about that one day. But remember this. That means if they knock the door of law, who law represent? If you are going to think with me, who law represent today? So remember who? Because Jesus said as was in the time of Noah, as was in the time of law. So my question is, who do you think law represent today? The Seventh-day Adventist Church. You remember the church? But do you think that these homosexuals will knock the door of Adventism? It's already there. Let me show you this. Let me show you. Maybe you move on and then you don't know. But don't do this. Okay, friends, we just have a problem on technique, but we are going to fix it. Okay, brothers and sisters, the Bible says we are in the end of this earth. But my friend, please don't look down, don't be as I don't know, but think, friends, if we are in the end of everything, what do you think we're supposed to be going right now for us to be prepared? But where Jesus is, right? And Jesus is the most holy place.
So we need to go where Jesus is. All our praying, all our mind, we have to focus in there. And I told you this week, I told you that God, one word, God is preparing a people that they must be what? They must be what? Prepared for this, they must be prepared because they will be a Christ. Now, brother and sister, we need to understand that the Lord, the reason why He's giving us all these messages that we are studying, especially this week, is because God wants what? God wants to finish that word that is actually. God wants to finish this word that He's giving to us. And we saw that the greatest word that we have is what? What is the greatest word? What is the greatest word that we have? What is the great work that God needs to do in our life? Sorry? Yes, it's a cleansing. The cleansing is true. But there's a cleansing because God wants to do something. He wants to cleanse us so that we may look like who? Jesus. Now, brothers and sisters, this is very, very important to take a look. Now, we saw this. Now, we saw also the counterfeit man. Now, also the counterfeit side. This is called, what is it? What is this? Have you ever seen this? This is called Seventh-day Adventist. Right now. They are Adventists. Listen to me. These people are Adventists. I read about them. I saw about them. I saw everything that they say about. They even have a page on Facebook. And these people, the goal is that we need to embrace them. Remember this. They are not rejecting the action. They should be doing the same thing. But they call themselves Adventists. And they say God's going to love us in this way. Yes, God loves sin in the street. But our brothers and sisters, God hates sin. Sins. Not the sinner, but sin. Now, God loved the alcoholic, but God hate what? Alcohol. God hate what? Prostitution, but God what? Love the prostitute. Now, we understand this. God never reject the people, but God what? Reject sin. Because sin is the thing that separates from God. Now, how about this? The angel, when they came to Sodoma, they came and then, Lord, I wonder if right now their angel are trying to save us. I wonder if there is angel are trying to tell us, my brothers and sisters, wake up. Because the time has come that you must be ready before the thing will break. And you cannot get ready when the crisis are broken. Can you read like that? What happened to Joseph? Joseph in Egypt, before the famine, he prepared. He made sure everything are right so that they will face the 7 years of trouble. Now, brothers and sisters, it's the same thing. So the angel came, get ready. Get ready, because there is a problem. But Lord was led. I wonder, because remember, there is a connection between Sodom and Gomorrah and right now this. Because Sodom and Gomorrah was back then. Jesus says it was in time of law. It still happens in our time. Right now, this system is actually officially called Seventh-day Adventist. Now, brothers and sisters, this is a very serious thing. We are, you know, we are, and you know, even though we see all these things, but we're not ready. Everything is ready, but we. Our question should be, Lord, what do you want me to do? What is the thing that is in my heart, that is in my life, that I need to get out of my life so that I can only have the love of Jesus? Because right now, we love a lot of things. A lot of things, brothers and sisters. There must be a great sacrifice that we need to do. See, somebody says, when she saw the vision, like many people, when they were going to this path, going to heaven. They say many people carry their property and all their riches. And then they say, we are going to heaven like that. There is no sacrifice. God doesn't even reach us. So she says that the more they was going, the path was getting hard. Narrow and narrow and narrow. As a result, the only way for you to pass, because remember, if Jesus is the way, Jesus must shape us. Yes or no? Jesus must what? Refine us as a refiner of gold. And you will not just allow, he will see a defect of character in you. You say, I need to bring this man in the family. Shake them. He take you somewhere else. Shake. He want to make everything to be shared. The question is, we need to be willing, because God is working. And she says that these people, some of them, they start to go back. They say, no, if you cannot pass without a chariot or horse, so you cannot continue. Because you cannot be no horse. They say, they go back to the wine path. But those people say, no, I want to follow this path. They start to leave all the horse, the chariot, and they take down their baggage. And there was while they was moving, the path getting more and more small, and they overthrown those things also out. Until they only heard, didn't have anything in their hand. That's what. That's why you say, let us lay aside how much? Every way. What else? And see which beset us so easily. If you want to continue this journey with brothers and sisters, then we need to do that. Then we need to do that. It's already broken. Okay. If you want, please. Now, my brothers and sisters, this homosexual or same-sex marriage is not the last sin. Babylon is many sin, okay? But it's not the last sin. There's something else that is about to come. That one is called National Sunday Law. Yes, ma'am. Now, the National Sunday Law is something, just remember this. If Mary's and Sabbath are what? Twin. That means the devil has also two twins. The first is already born. Yes or no? Amen? Mm-hmm. The first twin is already born. Yes or no? 2014. That means he's about what? To wait for the second twin. Now, twins, they don't take so long. Mm-hmm. They don't take so long to do what? To come out. The first come, the other one will come. Remember, this is a counterfeit. The devil is about to bring the second one. And the Bible says when America speaks like a dragon, that's the time. You know this America that you see right now? This will be a terrible country. I'm telling you, there are many people who love that country. But then this country will be regard everything called the righteousness of God. They will reject all this and they will embrace every satanical thing. Right now in the U.S. there is a church called what? Lucifer Church. There is a church called Satanical Church. What they do there is to worship the devil. Many singers that you love them and you listen to them and you think all these people are God. Actually, be careful, brothers and sisters. You guys are singing. Be careful that you don't only take the style of how they sing. Because I'm telling you, everything that these people do, they are doing this for Satan. I wish to tell you all these things, but I'm telling you, be careful, don't imitate that. If you want to imitate, go to the Bible. See how David sung. See how all these people actually and practice their song. Now, because that's very important if you do that. Okay, yes. Now, what is this? Who is this? Who is this? The Pope. No. This Pope is different. Why is it different? You know, this Pope knows how to cope. You know that? This Pope knows how to cope. In 1 year, 2015, he could go to every country in the world. And you listen to the video, don't watch actually has a presentation talk about every place that this man went. Even to the place where ISIS would meet in the Middle East, to the place which no other pope went there. The men could gather all together. What was the year that they signed that we need to have one religion? What was the year? What was the year, brothers and sisters? Yes, I think this was not there, but Philippines was the country which represented the Catholic Church. They signed. Not people from Rome, but the people who signed, the person who signed for the, ecumenical, religious, or people, or group of people, was from the Philippines who represent the Catholic. There was the Buddhist, and the Muslim, all these people. Every church, every denomination came together in 2014. Brothers and sisters. You know, brothers, all that God is doing right now is to reach us. My question is, are you ready? This is my question. Are you really ready for the coming of the Lord? Because my brothers and sisters, for us to be ready for the coming of the Lord, it's not enough to go to church. Do you know that? It's not enough to bring a speaker in, speaking to us. The purpose of speakers is to bring a message that can wake us. Because right now, we are deep in deep sleep. But remember this.
Only those people who go with Jesus in the muscle will receive the power. Now, what is this? Notice what the Pope said. You know this Pope? In 5 minutes, become very famous. In 5 minutes, the whole world knew him. 2013. And when this man came out, you know, in the same time, many people, he was in the cover of every magazine. Whether it's gay magazine, lazy magazine, sport magazine, every magazine he was there. That's why I told you, this man know how to pop. Because never any pop was in a gay magazine. But he was there. They put him there. Because why this? Because this is the reason why. The reason is because of what is it? He said, if someone is what? Gay. And that's what? Searching for what? The Lord. As a good will. Who am I to do what? We should do what? So, you know, this man is saying, you know, my brother and sisters, all these are going to a place which Revelation 20 verse 3 says. I saw one of these heads. How many heads is the beast of Revelation 20? You know, the Bible is based in number 7. You know that? Everything is 7, and 7 is always the last number. You read Revelation, everything is 7. 7 seal, 7 churches, 7 trumpet, 7 plague, everything. But when it's 7, that means we are in the beginning or in the end. Mm-hmm. Now listen to me, brothers. The deadly wound that was healed, not the first head, not the second head, not the other head, but what the Bible said, the last head. I wonder if we are in the last head. But everything right now is showing me that actually we are in the last head. My brother says, I wish to show you, but we will not show you this. But this is the reason why, brother and sister, we need to do something. Open your Bible in the book of Luke. Let's read the book of Luke. Let's read the book of Luke, and then we are going to jump somewhere else. I'm going to show you something there. Because before, you know, but for the national assembly law to pass, there must be a decree. Are we together? There must be a decree, and this decree will proclaim something. Now, when Jesus came, the Bible says, when Jesus came on earth, it was 4,000 years of this earth. But remember this, not 4,000 years without sin, 4,000 years of sin. Because many people don't understand that this planet will only have 6,000 years. Do you hear what I say? How many years? This planet earth, the Bible, the Scripture, the prophets tell us that we only last for how many years? How many? But if you study the history and you study everything, you found out that the planet is over 6,000 years. Yes or no? Yes or no? Oh, come on, guys. It's over the 6,000 years. But this over is not of sin. There was a period that there was no sin in the planet. And then the counting is only since the time of sin entered into the world. Now, brothers and sisters, when Jesus came on earth, the planet was how many? 4,000 years. Let's read this. Luke chapter 2. Let's read Luke chapter 2. Let me know by saying amen. Verse 3, the Bible says, verse 3. And all went to what? Now verse 2, what's this? Verse 3 to 4. All went to what? To be what? Tax. Everyone in the world, in his own towns. And Joseph also went where? Up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth and Judea. And unto the seat of what? David, which is called Nazareth. That's what it say? Where Mary and Joseph lived before? Huh? Where they live? Where did that come? Huh? Nazareth. But something happened that Joseph went from Nazareth going to where? What happened? Anyone know what happened? To make them to go to that place? Let's read verse 1. And it came to pass, on those days, they went where? What went? A decree. Now, what is the next name for the decree? A law. Are we together? They went a decree, a law. Then it says, from Caesar August, that all the world should be what? Father, sister, listen again. In that time, Caesar August was the emperor of God. And Rome in that days was not any ordinary king. It was the number one, the most powerful kingdom of that time.
And as America is today, that was wrong back then. Now, brothers and sisters, when Jesus was about to be born, when the 4,000 year was about to be accomplished, something happened on the ground. And the Bible said there was war, a decree. And this decree forced even the pregnant woman to go to a place. No one here been pregnant, right? But you, huh? Now listen, you know, if a woman is pregnant, how do you get? And then it's just left maybe 2 days. That's 2 days. Do you think that woman can go to a place like from here all the way to Manila? Maybe Nazareth was far, Bethlehem, but Rab was far than that. And imagine Mary and Joseph, because the decree of the king, which is the law, forced them to move. So there is no option, because they sell all the world to the world. And the great plot of time make Jesus to born in the right place at the right world. Because the prophecy says, foretold, that Jesus is supposed to be born not in Nazareth, but where? So it was because of that that Jesus moved. My brother and sister, before this world ends, before everything like that, they must be also pass a decree. And what is this decree is going to be? This is the decree. That's why I have to show you. This is the thing that I have to show you. Right now, there are agencies of evil that combine their force and consolidate. And they say they are what? Strengthened for the last great war. Great changes are soon to be what? My brother and sister. And the final movement will be what? Rock, what? But listen to everybody. Right now, there are things that is going on and most of us here are not aware. He says, what am I going to do? Okay, this one. By the what? Enforcing the institution of the papacy in violation to what? To the law of God, our nation, who is talking here? Who is talking? Huh? Anyone? What is the nationality of God? U.S. So it's mentioned about their own nation. To say our nation, didn't say our nation's plural. It's a one. Talking about U.S. We will disconnect ourselves fully. That means there will be no anything called Jesus anymore in U.S. They say fully well from consciousness. Because right now, that beast has 2 horns which look like what? Horns of man, which represent devil. Land represents Jesus. That means there is a watch. There is a connection. There's something about God. But there will be a time, and this time we are almost here. But this is it says that the nation will be fully disconnected from the righteousness. And when the Protestantism shall be what? Straight hands across the world. Go to grasp the hand of what? Everything right now, brothers and sisters, is going to the mother of harlots. Everything, you read everything. The economy, you know, when the Pope went to America, he says, we are going to war. No, the Pope never went to America. It's never happened in the history of America. But he went there. And when they went there, the magazine says, the reason why he was going there, he wanted to address 2 things. One is family, another one is economical crisis. Economical problem. So he want to solve. Because listen to me. The Bible says, when the mark of the beast will be enforced, only those who have the mark of the beast will do what? Can buy and sell. So that means there is something that's going to happen in the U.S., in every country of the world, that will affect every country of the world, that will introduce the new system of economy. Let me tell you, some people here, they did business. But I'm telling you, my friends, I don't know what we're going to do with the business. But anyway, you did business. It's okay. You're accomplished. But listen carefully. But listen. The Bible says there will be no what? Buy and? Now the Pope, when he went there, his agenda was to address 2 things. Family. They say we need the Sabbath to rest more so that our family can be strengthened. Listen what I'm telling you. I didn't put it there. But what it means when he says Sabbath is not the 7 days. Because in the commandment, in the catechism of Catholic, it's written that thou shalt what? Keep the Sabbath out. But that Sabbath that is written there is not the 7 day. And it says that he also going to address family problem. Now what do you think he's going to do? My brother and sister, when the Bible says, the mark of the beast will be enforced, there is something that is going to happen, my friends, which will be the economy. Listen to me, whether you like it or not, I'm doing it. The economy of U.S. The year of 2000, that economy reached the peak, reached the top of all the highest economy of the world. That's why they become a powerful even in their economy. But right now, it's going down. And listen, it's gonna, the prophecy tells us that the economy of U.S. will collapse completely. Did you hear what I said? Now, I'm gonna tell you the reason why it will collapse. The economy of U.S. dollar that we are using right now will lose its value very soon. And it will collapse completely. I don't have this presentation, but I'm just giving you this. And when the collapse will be happening, you know what will happen? There will be a revolution. And this revolution will be not just in the U.S., the prophet said it will be in every country in the world. But notice this. For the economy to be restored back, will be introduced a new system. And that system is called the system of the world, the peace. That's why there will be no buy and sell unless you receive what? The mark of the peace. I'm actually summarizing this to you, but this is a reality. This is a reality. The economy will completely what? I like this presentation for you. I mean today. Now, friends, please, I want you to go back to the, my friends, now, brother, sister, now, my question, I have a question for you, what God give us of it? Many people do not believe where? In the prophet. Yes or no? How many people believe in the prophet? Let's run quickly. How many people believe in the prophet? Can you see the name of those people who believe in the prophet? Some people, they don't believe. If you believe in the prophet, then you may know. There are a lot of things that we need to do right now, friends. Yes, we need to go into the most holy place with Jesus. We also need to be changed. But we also need to understand the time that we have. And friends, I don't have time for this, but I wish to tell you this, because it's about Moses. When Moses wrote, when Moses wrote the book of the law, where the book of the law was put up? In the most holy place with the law of God, yes or no? I wish to tell you, but I don't have time for this. But many people don't believe what this says. The question is, when Moses died, was the book of the law that he wrote was continued, yes or no? Yes. The book of the law continued. Even though Moses died, but the book went in the promised land. The people used the book of the law and the law. That's why Jesus said, I didn't come to destroy the prophet and what? And the law. And we also started this week that it's important to believe in the prophet, especially Moses, because Moses was a special prophet. Now, Moses was the only prophet who brought Israel out of where? Out of Egypt. And then if Moses brought Israel out of Egypt, to bring them in the promised land, but Moses didn't end. Moses was a special prophet or any prophet. Tell me. Special prophet. Because he was the one who brought Israel out of Egypt. So Moses was the prophet of what? The movement. Are we together? Moses was the prophet of the movement. Now, when we look to this, Moses also, the book of the Lord that he wrote, that is called the writing of what? The writing of what? What Moses wrote is called the writing of what? The prophet. How do you get it? Because he's the one who wrote it. Now, friend, this always says, this prophet, she's an anti-type of Moses. Let me show you an example. First, number one, Moses was a prophet, the only prophet who brought Israel out of where? Israel. That prophet was the prophet of the movement. And he wrote the book called the Book of the Law. Many people say the Book of the Law was the book, was nailed on the cross because it was the ceremonial law. Now, the ceremonial law was also in the Book of the Law, but the Book of the Law was larger than the ceremonial law. In that book, it's written what? the system of what? Education, the system of living, the system of eat and drink, everything was in that book. And Israel should find. How many books was it about? Now, notice this. Notice. Genesis what? So when Moses wrote those books, where those books were, put it on. Beside them. Because Moses wrote those books before he died. That's the book of the law. The people call it the book of the law. Even the Jews right now call it the book of the law. Now, even though he died, but the book continued. This prophet, she wrote. And her writing is called the writing of the prophet. She is the prophet of the movement of the seventh-day what? Adventist. Not to go to the promised land on earth, but going to the promised land where? Are we together? Now, even though she died, many people ask her, they say, the question is sometimes right. What if it misses us to be what? Now, I answer the book that what? She is with them, we know what? Please, we are not talking. The book that she has what? Written shall do what not? My friend, I see you, Father, please help us. Help us, Lord, that we not be distracted, but may listen to your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, what is this? He said, the book that she has what? They are living witness for what? So what the prophet wrote is a living witness for the scripture. But I'm going to show you something, if whether we should really follow the prophet. Now, this says, many get up skin after what? Skin. And the enemy, who is the enemy? Who is the enemy? Satan. The enemy will do what? Seduce all from the truth. But all who believe that the Lord has spoken through Sister White and has given her a message will be lost from the many. Now we say, will be saved from the many delusions that we want come in this last day. You know, right now there will be a lot of deception. But there is something that God is going to do to protect us by using the prophet. Does the Bible say that? Do you think the Bible says this? What was it? Hosea chapter 4. Hosea, the Bible says this. The Bible says this because everything that the Bible says, the prophet says. And everything that the prophet said, the Bible also said. Let me read Hosea chapter 12. Let me know by saying amen. Now, let's open our Bible. Now, we didn't read yet our scripture. I'm going to show you the reason why. This one, Hosea 12, verse 10. Are you in Hosea 12, verse 10? Are you there? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's read together. It says, I also did what? Spoken by how many prophets? That's plural. Prophets, and I did what? And I multiplied vision and similitude by the ministry of what? So that means being a prophet is a ministry. Now, by the ministry of the prophet, but brothers and sisters, let's read together. Okay, God used all many prophets. But let's read together verse 13. Are you there? Let's read verse 13. Are you there? Let's read together. Okay. The Bible says in verse 13, what did the Bible say? By a prophet. It didn't say prophets. It said by what? One prophet. The Lord brought Israel out of it. Egypt represents what?
The world.
And it said, what happened here? Today, Egypt represents the world. Okay? Out of Egypt. And by a prophet, Israel did what?
Preserve.
Now my question is like this. What is preserve? What is it? When you say preserve, that means you are protect. Yes or no? So the Bible is saying, Adam and Lisa, that God used one prophet to do what?
Preserve.
Now that's what you do, are you using preservative? What do you do with the preservative? It's to protect. For example, when you put preservative in the food, it's to protect the food from what? And if the food, they didn't know, be careful, because there are some preservatives, you know, I read about ice cream. There is, please, those people are eating ice cream. I'm just want to tell you this. You can go, maybe YouTube, just found out, maybe just like ice cream, danger ice cream, maybe just like that. I don't know, I forgot the name. But there is this man talking about the ice cream. There is a kind of ice cream which is not natural ice cream. That ice cream does not melt. You can put it on the sun for 1 week, you know, man. And there are people who are eating that kind of ice cream. I'm telling you, if it's something you eat and then stay there for a week, that's what kind of Lord. You see, that's the problem. That's why we get sick so easily. Now, that is this. It says preservative is to protect. But this preservative that we're talking about is a helpful one. Preservative. Now, the purpose of preservative is to protect the food from spoil. Now, if a prophet's job is to protect the people, is to preserve God's people, that means everyone who is just a prophet right now, they are almost black spot. So if I reject the prophet, you know what will happen? I will receive the mark of the beast. If I reject the prophet, I will wander after the beast, because the prophet talk about the beast. If the prophet talk about a lot of things, and you want to know what the things are talking about? A lot of things. I say a lot of things, and you are going to see some of them. Let me show you this. This sanctuary is very important, brothers and sisters. This is not the thing that I don't have time to show you this, but I want to show you this. For example, there are people right now who are thinking that they can play any kind of music in the church. I went to a church, I don't know, some of my classmates, I think they graduated, but I went together with them, it's in my head. So this church, I had the video, I recorded it. And of the church, you would hear drums. And everything, you know, right now, not just in the Philippines, actually the Philippines is actually better. You go in my country, maybe it's worse. You go everywhere in the continent that you can go, you will see that people, the way they worship, is what they do is what we call, I call it, what the people do is, you know what they do? They use drums and guitar and all these things, and the people, like somehow, you know, even some people dance. You know, I saw a video in the U.S., and not the U.S., just South Africa. It's in South Africa. In South Africa, people enter the church dance. And the reason why people are doing this is because they think they dance. I told you, none of the people in the Bible is our descendant father, but only Jesus. Yeah. But I'm not saying that what David did is wrong. David was hard. But my question is, where David danced? It was in the temple or outside of the temple. When Miriam danced, as the Bible says so, in Exodus, she was happy and rejoiced. I wonder what kind of dance. Do you think it's the dance of Tarashina that people do anyway? You think so? You know, you think that one? It has nothing to do, brothers and sisters. But notice the prophet says, this, actually the prophet prophesied this 100 years ago. Now what does he say? They said, the Lord has shown me what? Clearly that the image of the beast will be what? Fall before progression call. Now, I want to move on. I cannot stay here. I need to move on. I cannot show you this. But I have to show you. Now I was also instructed to say that at this demonstration, what demonstration? Let's read this one. The image of the beast will be crossed. When the image of the beast will be formed? Tell me. Remember, there is the beast and the image of, those are different things. But the image of the beast will be formed before progression grows. Right now, the image of the beast is being formed. You know what is the image of the beast? Anyone know what is the image of the beast? The image of the beast is the Protestant world which embraces what? The state and unite and with what? With a Catholic or Roman Catholic church. But notice this. I cannot explain you everything today, but notice this. For it is to be what? The great test for the world. The people of God. By which they are eternal, this will be what? Decided. This is the test that we want. The people of God must be what? Held for what? Before they are sealed. Now there will be a test. Because God cannot seal anyone if we are not passing the test. First the test, then the seal. No pass the seal, the test, no seal. And people say we are going to be sealed. The test is the national assembly. That will be the great test that we're going to face. If we pass the test, we can receive the seal of God. Adam did not pass the test as he went before. But not after that. Notice it. It says, all who approve their word, loyalty to God, by observing his law and refusing the what? The story is out. We what? Now, but those who yield the truth of heavenly origin and accept the Sunday, those who what? Yield the what? Of the heavenly origin and what? Accept the Sunday Sabbath, we will receive what? I was instructed that okay, this will happen outside of the church. By the probation, before the probation clause, there is something that will happen outside of the church, which is this one. What is this again? The enforcement of national Sunday law, and the people have to decide. Not just Adventists, even the people who are in the car, everyone will decide. Now we say here, there's something that happened in the church. It says, I was instructed to say that those at this demonstration, demon are what? Is it the one that I'm going to show this one? The thing you have described as taking place where? And where the Lord has shown me what? That there will be what? Take place just before what? So before probation clause, there are two things that will happen. One in the world, which is the mark of the beast and the image of the beast. But another thing is to be seen. What is going to happen in the church that the Lord showed to the prophet? Every uncouth thing will be what? Demonstrated. There will be what? Shout. What else? Drum. What else? Music. What else? Dance. And the saints of rational being will become how? So confused that they cannot be trusted to do what? To make the right decision. And this is called what? Right now, every music that people are playing, drums, dancing, and all this that people are doing, right now, the people are being in their Holy Spirit. This is the what? The Holy Spirit. This is a time to be Holy Spirit. But the scripture says this will happen before progression clause. And right now we are in this case. I wonder if we are near the progression of this. You know, if you study the Bible, you see that in the Day of Atonement, people don't use drums, don't use shouts, because there is only agonizing. They don't use what? Music and dancing. They only pray, Lord, please, did you forgive me already? Did you take my sin? Did you cleanse me? Did you bring me to the image of Jesus? This is what people do. They don't dance. There is no such thing of excitement. But this, if you play this kind of thing, that will bring you the most of the best. Now, Psalms 92 talk about that. And also, Chronicles talk about that. That in the Day of Atonement, people only use what? Hymn song. Like the way the Arthur just sung me. Hymns song. Okay? I want to tell you all this about right now. I was instructed that to say that, and that this demonstration of demon is what? In the form of man. That means those people are dancing, shouting, screaming, drums, and all this, they say actually demons are present there. And they are helping them to play, dancing with them. It says demons in the form of men are present, working with what? All one. In Trinity, that Satan cannot enjoy to make two distinguished of God, sensible people. That the enemy was what? Trying to arrange a matter to do what? So that the company, the people do that actually in the company. What's going to happen to them? Which has been mean of bringing the truth. So the company is supposed to bring the truth, which is of the third angel's message before the multitude, should be what? Lose their force and all. So the devil, when people are bringing a place like this, my brother, we are not talking. Listen. When God is bringing a message like this to his people, he brings destruction. He brings all these so that people cannot have the influence of the third angel message, and also they cannot be prepared. I'm telling you, without the third angel message, they cannot be prepared. Now the Holy Spirit never revealed itself in such a method of what? Of none. This is the invention of Satan to cover up what? Is a genuine method of what? For making no effect of what? Pure, sincere, elevating, and loving what? Sanctifying you like this. You know, this kind of music, if you play, you can play those music in the outer world, but not in the muscle world. But we are in the day of atonement, we know that. In the day of atonement, our music should change. You think our dress should be changed? You think our food should change? You think our way of conversation should be changed? Everything when the day of atonement about this had to change. Let me show you. That's what I have to show you. Okay? You know, the Bible actually talks about strange fire. Right now, people are bringing strange fire in the church. I won't let some people die because of the strange fire that I bring inside. Now, because those people brought the strange fire, I'm telling you the history of music. And even the Vatican too, but I don't have time to show you all this. That even in Daniel, remember this. In Daniel chapter 3, what the devil used for him to bring all multitude, the whole world, to worship the image that was in Daniel chapter 3. Yes. The Bible says, how many kinds of music are the king used? What did the devil use? All kind of music. You read that in the Bible. So that means if the devil is going to make people to worship the image of the beast, he must also use the same method. And right now people embrace change, embrace everything. As a result, we are taking from the world and bring it inside. Now what does he say? The devil is going to make you be different. Hate. Now I don't have time to explain you these things, but what do you think? What is it? He says, I saw that the remnant were what? Who is the remnant? It's us. Even though everything is going this way, but we're not prepared for what is what? To come upon the earth. Stupidity what? It's not me who said it, it's the prophet. He said, stupidity. And what else? You know what is better? Sleepy, lazy, right? He said, seem to do what? Now, okay, this is the problem he says, stupidity. No one likes to be called stupid. Yes? But the prophet said, actually, we are. Now, my question is, what do you think how we are stupid? What kind of stupidity do you have? Because he said we are stupid. And this is straight truth. And we don't like to hear that. But I'm thinking the prophet is saying we are stupid. Listen to this. I'm going to give you a second. If a man is riding a car, okay? Please listen carefully to this example. He's riding a car, and in the front, and he's speeding out. Maybe I don't know how many kilometers. He's really fast. And then, there is a cliff before him. You know what's a cliff, right? And all of a sudden, somebody will tell him, brother, there is a cliff there. You have what? So if you hear that, and then you are blind, and then you don't know, you know, when they say a cliff, you cannot even maybe see. And if you can just speed out, and there's a cliff. But if this man, even though there is a cliff, but he said, what? There's a cliff? I don't care what I'm saying. And then he speed up more and then go. He's not stupid, yes or no? That man is stupid, amen? That man is stupid. Now, what is this? We are going fast and there is a cliff. Our time is running out, and instead of giving our heart to Jesus, we are giving our heart to the devil. Instead of giving our life to Jesus, we are giving everything that we have to Satan. This is what we call stupidity. Jesus said, do not love the world, the things of the world, but you have to follow me, or you follow the devil. This is what we call stupidity. Because in other words, we want to kill ourselves. And we want to kill ourselves, this is called stupidity. I know we don't like to do this, but I'm telling you. That's why our question to the Lord, what is the thing that I'm actually embracing, and this thing actually is what? Of the world. This thing is of the world. Now my question is, does in the most holy place, does God accept what? Does God Okay, let me show you. Does our habit of eating and drinking is acceptable? Or, I mean, can take the glory of God? Yes or no? Can take, yes or no? He said either can take or either what? Leave the glory of God. But notice this. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 31 is written there. What is written there? Whether we eat or whatsoever we do, do is how? For the glory of God. Then we found out this kind of food cannot take out the most of the things. And there is a reason for that. If you are eating in this kind of diet, you will remain out of God. But somebody say, no, but Jesus ate fish. I'm going to ask, Jesus didn't eat meat. But my question is, when Jesus ate fish, where did Jesus eat fish? In the outer court or in the most holy place? Huh? In the outer court or in the most holy place? In the outer court. When he was here already. And then when Jesus eat meat, you remember when Jesus eat meat? When every Jew eat meat? Passover. But on the Day of Atonement, no Jews eat meat. There's a special fast for them. And they throw everything that can divert their mind. Because you know, there's a reason why we should not go into this kind of diet. I'm going to show you. I don't know. You know? Have you ever seen this one? Have you ever seen this in this one? Let's read this one. Animals are what? More and more disease. And it will not be long until animal food will be what? Given done by many beside who? When you say many beside, what do you mean? Many beside Adventists mean non-Adventists. Right now, there are many people who are vegan. Yes or no? There are many people who practice sport and doing all these things, runner. All of them, they want to be vegan. Because they say, I want to be a healthy body so that I can do my work properly. And these people are not Adventists. See, so my point is this way. Many beside Adventists are no longer used animal food. But we Adventists say, no, I want cheap. I want to rest. But there is a reason why we need to leave this food, not just because of healthy, but because of the day that we are living. Because the angel says, fear God and do what? Give glory to Him, for the hour of His judgment has come, and worship Him. That means our worship has to change, our diet has to change. Everything about our life has to change. Why? Because we cannot eat wrong food, which destroy our body. Because if I eat animal, which are diseased, I'm destroyed. I'm shorting my life. If I'm shorting my life, I'm breaking the commandment of God, which is the sixth. And remember, the duty of the most holy place is that, what is the duty of the most holy place? The keeping of what? God's law. So if you're not willing to keep the God's law, you cannot enter it. You gotta go back to the outer court. But on the Day of Atonement, we need to be with Jesus. And we need to be where He is. We need to learn this and practice. Friends, if you cannot practice this, you're in trouble. I know many people, there are other people, people should tell me I'm doing this. But actually, the prophet says, these have to be progressive. Amen? The diet reform has to be what? So you leave pork, and then you move for chicken. You leave chicken, you move for. Then you move progressive. And when you get vegetarian, when you go to vegetable or whatsoever is the thing that you call, you also have to move largely to what? And wrong. They say to be progressive. And not just like that, let the people be taught how to do what? How to prepare food. So I cannot just quote people to tell them, but I have to teach them. And I praise God that in Bible study, we are going to have this lesson. Though it's delayed, can't fall. Now, listen to this. There's a reason why is it. He says, tell the people what? That the time will soon come when there will be no what? No safety, no what? Using eggs, being cream, what else? Because, why? Why there's no safety of those things? Because of what? Disease in what? Increasing in proportion to what? By the way, my friend, listen to me. The reason why you are here in this school, even the cafeteria is not chicken. God wants to teach us to learn this. Because why this is the day that we're living, this school was established for us to learn this. This school, the purpose of this university, Adventist University, is for to learn this, to practice. and to follow Jesus. And to remember that we need to live this in our way so we can follow Him. Because this can destroy our body. The Bible says, those who destroy their body, God will not do what? Destroy them. Now, the disease are increasing proportional to what? To the wickedness of man. Now, increase here is all proportional to increasing. Now, this is time. Do you know what this magazine? This is not Adventist magazine. This is a world magazine. What if? 1994. What they said? In this year, they already understood that animals had a problem. 1994. Now, notice this thing. Because you need to watch. Notice this. Can this mean what? Can this mean this what? It's September 1997. They found out that the meat actually can destroy us. This is the world. It's not like this. That means the world has become more intelligent than us. The children of the world have become more wiser than the children of the world. Jesus said that. Now, notice this. Our safety food supply is what? Healing us. Now, this is said 310,000 Americans a year going to where? Going everywhere to the grave. How many people? 310,000 die early before they're supposed to die. Now, and the reason is because there's no safety. You want to say? Now, this is says, should you? This is time. Should you be what? The world is not Advent. This is the world. What year? You know what year is this? 2002. Now, my friend, if the world actually is understanding this, why us we still impress? Listen, there will be a shaking in this church. God is going to shake out those people who don't want to impress what? His message. And those who are out there, those who impress, the Bible says they will receive the letter right, and they will go where God wants them to go. And they will present this message, and the world will come to inside of the church. My brothers and sisters, if we are not willing, that means if I'm not willing to give up certain things for God, it only means that I have less love for Jesus. Are we together? But this time is for us to have what? The love of God. We found out that Daniel actually had also a different dime. We read this quotation yesterday. Now, why this is it? I want to check this. I have to pass this guy. Why is it? What is it? Do you think our habit of dress also can also take the glory of God? Let me show you. He says, the prophet says here, fashion is what? And what? Eating out what? Of our people. Obedience to fashion is what? Preventing our Seventh-day Adventist churches. And what? Is winning more than any other power. Now, my brother says, listen to me. This is says, what is destroying our spirituality is what? Fashion. The Bible says, be not what? Fashion. It doesn't say, be not conformist, be fashionable. Don't be fashioned to the world, but let your mind be what? Renewed. He said, do not be fashioned to the world, to the power of the world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. So, this is the Bible. Now my question is, what kind of fashion that actually destroys us? Any fashion of the world. That's what the Bible says, do not love the world, because in the Day of Atonement, our love had to be for God, not for the world. Every love that we had now had to be for God. So it says, exhibition of pride in breast, which is forbidden in what? Should be sufficient reason for the church discipline. And he's saying here, what is he saying? Let's read this one. He said, if there is what, a continuous in the world. Read with me the what? Facing the one appeal and entreaty, say, to still follow the perverse will, it will be what? Be regarded as what? Profound as what? The heart is not what? Self and only self is what? So, brothers and sisters, it says, If we are not follow these, that means we are follow ourselves. Now, what are the things that God wants us to change? I want to show you this. I want to. You know, I don't have time to talk about this. I'm sorry. I have to pass this. You know, 50% of disease can be actually removed, can help woman if they follow the dress reform. 50%, that means half of the disease. The prophet said this. Half of the disease. Men have become what? Lifelong, involved, poor, what? They are complacent with the demand of fashion. Displacement and deformity. Cancer and what else? Other terrible diseases are among evil. Result of what? What is the result of this terrible disease? How would you get? What is the result of this? Fashionable dress. Half of this of disease on a woman are caused by what? The prophet says, if we can, our dress reform can solve 50% of disease, can solve cancer. There are people with cancer, not because they eat something wrong, it's because they eat drug, they dress wrongly. Now, this person, this is called Victoria's Secret World. This is a program on TV. How many of you know this? None of you know. This person is called Kylie Isu. She is not Adventist. Are you listening? But many words to say. Many words to say. She says, I have decided to leave what? Because it crashes with what? This is not Adventist. But she knows that her body was bought by Christ. My body should know what? Should only be for my husband. And it's just a what? Secret thing. She said, and the folks, you know, said, what is it? I didn't realize what? I want to be that kind of what? Born. And then she said, young girl, because what? I have a lot of what? So she was saying all this. She said, there are people who look at me, I want to dress what? Properly. Remember, she continued saying, she said here. She said, I just started to become what? More and more than the one. Because of my faith. I am a Christian and I what? I read the Bible more. The more I read the Bible, more I found my word. I was becoming more convinced about this. This is not Adventist, but she knows. But our address is Christian. Now she said, I decided not what? To model more what? Because I personally feel that what? I am not honoring God. Not even my husband. My Mary is more what? You know some people, they really consider their Mary. And he said, my Mary is very important. And like divorce and like what? To do what? To respect. God has graciously given you what? You see, this man had to, but he said all these things. But what is it? What is it? You know, this kind of thing cannot be given in a Muslim place. I will say this. We are Muslim, but this kind of thing cannot give you what? This kind of dress cannot give you in a Muslim place. But listen to this. God, listen to this. I see many people talk. God is not interested in condemnation. Did you hear what I said? Please. God is not interested in the word? Mm-hmm. But God will be indicators. God will teach us that on the day of atonement, even our dress change. Our eat change. Everything we do change. The people who use this, for example, you see this one? It's working. Heaven body is telling her, please reform your shoes. Condition in the gym. I wish to show you the danger of using heels. But I don't have time to show you. But you go online, read about it, just research and ask the danger of using it. Then you find out. Because I know all our sisters, I'm saying all our sisters, they use that. And they are our sisters. Yes. And God bought them, yes or no?
Yes.
But God wants to teach us what to educate us. How are we together? How are we together? Yes. Now, the extreme numbers. So any other more now. Now, notice this, the prophet was for us something. What's the extreme one? Extreme numbers.
This is extreme, amen.
Amen.
This is extreme, yes or no?
Yes.
This is extreme long dress, yes or no?
Yes.
Oh, come on, you're not even saying amen. This is extreme, because when you press this, it's going to pick up the dirt, pick up the water, pick up everything that you go, where you go. But this is when the fashion, the number six, all right? People dress something very long. But she said, to correct the extreme short dress, reach, what is the, where the extreme short dress reach? Reach. So she said, extreme, you know what we call right now, that is a decent dress, from the means, she called it extreme short dress. So there was two extreme. One is a long dress, the other one is extreme short dress. What is the long dress? That one will pick up everything. The long, the extreme short dress was the one that could preach more. Amen. But she said we need to shut both of the extreme. If we want to make it the most of the best preachers. But sisters, we don't have time and we need to finish it. I'm going to finish it. You know who made it? You know with this woman? Anyone know this woman? Okay, you want to know this woman was the one in 1964. That she invented mean shirt. You hear what I said? Mean what? Mean shirt. Thank you. But notice this. This woman, her name is Mary Quinn. Everyone right now is following this woman. As if she's a god. This is like this. She wanted to give the son. He said, Mary Quinn did what? Conquered the world. How many of you know this is? This, you know, Israel, you cannot deny this. Everything that we are doing, we are part of something. They say it's very big, conquer the world. And this is how many people was going to the street and going everywhere. Actually, there is a video. Actually, she talked about this very thing. She's from England. And so talk about with her and her husband, to talk about this thing, why they did it. The very purpose why they made the minister is that they say it's to make more, it's to make sex to be available in the daytime. You hear what I say? To make what? Sex available when? To be more attractive. Now what is it? He said, I'm going to do this, but I will show you this. I put it here. It says, it's too poor. Sensuality and what? That's what the problem that was saying. This woman made this, and in 1969, in America, there was also what? It was okay then. Minister became popular in the United States of America, that even the Japanese, the Japanese embassy, the wife of that man, she also got to do it. But before then, no one used any kind of thing like that. And right now, become very popular, and you are finding, you are saying, oh, this is the right one. If I'm telling you, the dress that reached the knees is not the dress that the Bible will teach. The moment the Bible says that we should not show our sister, listen. My sisters, you are very important. This is, you know, this, you are, you know, you should be the thing that, I mean, the only thing that people should respect the most. The thing that God gave to men is women. And they are very available. I mean, they are very valuable. And this should be what? Protect. You know, when we start to expose our body, it's actually only attract one thing. I told you last time. You know when you expose, you know when you go to the market, you go to the market, In the market, you see those people are going to this market, Paseo there. You see, in Paseo there's a market. You know the market? Where there's those chimney over there. You know, I went there, there was tables, long table, and there was many kind of flesh. All type of flesh was there. But there's only one thing that attracts flesh. You know what's that? Huh? What is the thing that attracts flesh?
Flies.
Now anyone is flying here? Now remember this. The flies, the flesh usually what? Attract flies. Now, if you want to take the flesh out
having the flies out of the flesh, because they can spoil what's in the flesh. What are you going to do? Before you cover, you do something delicate. What is it? Wipe it away. Away, then you cover it. So, my friend, when our sisters, when we, you know, brothers, sisters, listen to me. When we expose our body, what we going to attract is only flies. And this fly, you know I checked. I know I found out a fly is not your job. A fly can play games and video games and things like that, not your job. And that man can make you a pregnant and leave you there. But God said, I don't want to give you a fly, I want to give you something better. Can you see that? But it says, that's why the Lord is telling us that we need to record our life. And my question is, listen. Before something happened outside, something first happened where? Something must happen our heart first. And if I'm not willing to give up things for God, whether it's in diet, whether it's in dress, whether it's in music, whether it's in whatsoever it is that the thing that I do, it means that I have less love. Less love. Now, I cannot show you the makeup, I'm sorry, but let's pray and ask God. Let's ask God, let's say, Lord, oh Lord, so much. Let's ask God and say, Lord, help us that we may embrace what you want us to do. You know, this is a problem. I wish to tell you this, but this is a problem today. This is not helpful. And you know, people say, no, but I want color, blue, green, and all this water. But the plan of redemption, when God redeems us, it doesn't change outside first, it changes first where? In heart. So something must happen here before we are changed. We are changed. Okay, let's pray. Now I want to invite those people who really want to pray and say, Lord, I want to follow the Bible. Remember, the Bible teaches modesty. The Bible teaches what we're supposed to eat and drink. The Bible teaches that in the Day of Atonement, everything about our life has to change. Now my question is, do you know what it takes for us to change? Anyone know what it takes for us to sacrifice everything for God? Anyone know?
Love.
Someone say?
Love.
Love. For God so loved the world that you are. Love help us to give up certain things for God. That's why Jesus said, if you love me. If you love me, what he said? So commandment is not just the 10 commandments. Commandment is everything that he said. You want to follow Jesus? You want to follow Jesus in the most of the place? You want to ask Jesus to help you? Yes or no? Because remember, without Jesus, we can do nothing. Now, I want to invite you, we will pray this closing prayer. I mean, this prayer of dedication. We will kneel on, and then we will sing our new song. Then we close our prayer. I want to give you time that you may talk to God personally, okay? And then ask Him to help us. Remember, for us to sacrifice anything for God, we must have the love of Jesus. Father, which I have, we thank you, Lord, for today. Lord, we have a lot to study. How can we go? Dear God, we pray that all that we have seen, that on the Day of Atonement, we need, Lord, to give our heart and we need to give everything of the world that we have embraced. Please, oh dear God, you told us that without me, you can do nothing. We need your help. We need your power. And Lord, it's taken love for us to sacrifice. And we are not willing to sacrifice the thing that you are telling us. So we pray, Lord, help us. Give us your love that you promised in Revelation 3. That faith and love that will help us, will make us, Lord, to sacrifice anything for Jesus. And take the world, its diet, its education, its teaching, its philosophy, its way of eating, its way of dress, its music, its amusement, take the world, but please give by Jesus. Lord, the Christ is coming, we are not prepared. Without Jesus, we cannot be prepared. And you cannot dwell where there is sin in the center, Lord. Please take everything which is in this, which is a stumbling block for you to abide in our heart. We praise you for speaking to us. We ask, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you.